sports fans and gamers. Mark Horner here from League Unlock, league analyst and talking head, coming at you once again for the Mayo Media Network to talk about some picks to make this weekend in the League of Legends scene. And yep, you guys know the deal. Before we get into those picks, make sure you are subscribing to the channel, leaving a like if you enjoy the video, and telling us down below what pick you like for this weekend. And if you need any extra fantasy sports action, make sure you are looking out for the Daily Fantasy Sports Picks and Bets The Mix podcast. Yes, that's your podcast if you're looking for some extra daily fantasy sports action. But now it's time for our picks. And when we're talking about our picks for this weekend, we are looking right away at the LPL, and we got a heavy showdown in between Suning and FPX. And yes, we want Fun plus Phoenix. That's FPX with that match line of -175. Why do we want FPX? How could you not want FPX? Yes, Suning has been doing better of late. And yes, Bin has been a big presence in the top side for them. Well, guess what? You're going to have to lane against Nuguri on the other side for FPX. And not just Nuguri is going well for FPX. LWX is dealing out massive damage in the bottom lane. And yes, Super Carry Doin B is doing some Super Carry type of things in the mid lane for FPX. We want FPX against Suning once again with that match line of -175. And for the next match, we are moving over to Europe, visiting the LEC. And we are going over for another matchup that is pretty juicy with Rogue versus Fnatic. And we want to get on that orange and black hype train. Yes, we're going with Fnatic against Rogue. Fnatic with that match line of -110. And why do we want Fnatic? Well, we're looking at what they have been doing well. Because yes, Rogue, as you should know by now, is if not a top two, top three team in the LEC, in the European region, and what they show. Why are we thinking that Fnatic can stack up to them? Well, there's a couple of reasons. And starting off, number one is going to be the job that Bwipo has done in the jungle since making the role swap change for this split. He absolutely has been a big impact in that role and have been finding many good engages for the team. And on top of that, adding in how he has played with their rookie top laner, Adam. Adam has certainly not been a rookie as far as the output and his performance. And even on top of, you know, putting a rookie type of label on him and seeing what he could do, you can remove that because he has just simply flat out been one of the best, if not the best, top laners in the region this whole split. Love what we've seen from him. And then, of course, can't be forgetting about my boy Niski in the mid lane. I think a lot of people have not paid enough respect to what he has been able to do. He has been massive for why Fnatic has found themselves rocketing up the standings in Europe. That is why we are taking the orange and black Fnatic hype train. And that is Fnatic with that match line once again of -110. Our next matchup is going over to the LCS. Yes, we're not forgetting about North America, and we're hitting up for the prime match of 100 Thieves versus Cloud9, and we want Cloud9. Yes, this is the Cloud9 bet that you've been looking for, finally finding some value for these guys and getting to go on the Perks train. And it is not just the Perks train anymore for Cloud9, because yes, Perks is fantastic, but the real reason, the big one, why we want to be putting our faith behind Cloud9 is about the top laner. It's about your boy Fudgecake in the top lane. What he can do against someday in a matchup. That is a crucial matchup in this game, but especially with looking at what advantages you can get for Cloud9, how you can put some pressure against an 100 Thieves team. An 100 Thieves team that has shown us not to nearly be as lethal as you would want them to be with leads that they have been able to acquire. That's why we're taking the value with Cloud9. Going to be able to find a bit of an upset for them to return to some good form in North America. That is Cloud9 with that match line of +100 against 100 Thieves. Yeah, 100 versus 100 Thieves. I know, guys. Now, for game four, we are heading back over to the LPL. We're going across the globe again and visiting for JDG versus your boys at RNG. We're looking for the returning MSI champions that have found their form again. That is Royal Never Give Up. We are taking them with that match line of -175. Why do we want RNG? Well, as I just said, they have fully returned back to the form that saw them win the spring championship in the LPL, saw them win the midseason invitational, Now they're back and they're roaring on all cylinders the way that they were going. We're talking about Xiaohu being a monster threat in the top lane. Gala dishing out outrageous damage from the ADC role. And yep, you heard me right. I didn't say anything about crying. Yeah, that's right. We didn't talk about crying. That's the secret for RNG. When you're able to talk about the positives in Xiaohu and what damage Gala is doing, and you're not mentioning mistakes coming across from crying in the mid lane, that's the secret sauce for RNG. That's RNG once again over JDG, taking them with that match line of minus 175. And our final match to close it out for the week is once again in the LCS. And we are looking at the prime matchup of TSM versus Cloud9. And we want TSM in this one. And you might be saying, well, you just told me Cloud9 against 100 Thieves. What's the difference with TSM? Well, the way TSM is going to roll on through, the way that TSM can match up against Cloud9, and specifically for me, I know this might seem a little strange to some people, but I think the matchup, Huni into Fudge, the one that we just stressed about Fudge against Someday and 100 Thieves, Huni is going to be the answer against Fudge for TSM. I think Huni has been fantastic this split. He has been able to get back to the level that we saw when he was playing on SKT, going to the World Championship Finals. That's the level we're talking about from Huni for TSM as well. I think that someone like Spica has shown us that he's been able to get the better of Blabber in certain situations, and certainly this split has shown us better form overall. That's why we're signing with TSM FTX. That is TSM with that match line of minus 120. All right, let's recap those five games for this weekend. We got some good juicy ones kicking things off in the LPL. Suning versus FPX. We're taking FPX with that match line of minus 175. The next one up is Rogue versus Fnatic, taking Fnatic with that match line of minus 110. And following it up with that 100 Thieves versus Cloud9 showdown in the LCS, we're taking Cloud9 with that match line of plus 100. Next game in the LPL, the final one for the week in China, is going to be JDG versus RNG, taking the MSI champions RNG with that match line of minus 175. And the last one for us, the last pick of the week, is the LCS matchup between TSM and Cloud9. And yes, that is going to be TSM that we are taking with that match line of minus 120. That's going to be it for me, guys. Let me know how these picks are working out for you, and I hope you have a great weekend.